PRS is probably one of the best guitars today dahil pinagsasama nito yung best features ng isang Les Paul at isang Strat. At dahil nasa modern era na tayo ng music production, a lot of musicians gravitate towards guitars na mas versatile or basically maraming kayang gawin. But there's just one problem with the PRS. It's very expensive. Unlike Fender and Gibson na may 20,000 range counterparts sa Squire and Epiphone, sa PRS, wala. Well, merong PRS SE pero 40,000 na yung pinakamura. And this one is actually 60,000. So talaga magbabasag ka ng wallet if you want to get the PRS experience. So do we have cheaper alternatives? Luckily, yes. So this is the new RJ Tone Master, a budget version of the PRS Custom 24, and a PRS 594. So ito na ba ang gateway ninyo sa PRS experience? Ako si Pax, and let's check out this guitar. So the Tone Master is part of the professional electrics line ng RJ. So ito ay nasa may higher end ng guitars nila. And for the Tone Master, meron tayong apat na models. The Standard, the Deluxe Plus, and the Deluxe Plus SE. It sounds complicated, pero lahat sila may same pickups and electronics, or in a nutshell, same sound. Well, almost. Generally, may nababawas lang sa specs as we go down the price. I'll explain along the way. Start with this bad boy, the Tone Master Deluxe Plus SE, also known as the budget PRS McCarty 594. Actually, na-impress ako dito kasi walang gumagawa nito sa budget range. Now, the 594 design is actually, in my opinion, the best PRS design kasi it has 4 knobs na parang Les Paul compared sa Custom 24 na 2 knobs lang, which I always find very limiting, especially for the price. Well, parehas silang mahal. Anyway, kung confused ka sa usapan na ito, check out this video that I made for PRS guitars para magets mo yung mga models nila. But as a simple guide, yung PRS Custom 24 ay yung parang flagship counterpart nila ng Stratocaster or Les Paul. Everything else is either above or below this model. Yung PRS 594 naman is like a Fender Stratocaster Ultra or a Les Paul Custom. Not the most accurate way to describe it, pero this will do for now. Okay, let's talk about specs. Yung body nitong Tone Master Deluxe Plus SE ay mahogany with flamed maple top, parang sa PRS. But again, veneer lang ito. An easy way to know if your PRS has a solid flame top is by looking at its binding. Faux binding ang tawag dito, katulad din dito. Basically, in-strip lang yung paint para magmukhang binding. And as you can see dito sa may US model, kahit sa gilid, makikita natin yung stripes ng flame top. Moving forward, this color is called Whale, in reference to PRS's faded whale blue. This is actually a famous and hard to find color sa PRS. Usually, sa mga sobrang mahal na PRS nyo lang ito makikita, at madalas, sold out. Anyway, sa 4 models, ganito lahat yung wood combination, maliban sa Tone Master Standard, which has pure mahogany, parang sa PRS SE Standard. Now, let's check out the neck. Mahogany ang wood nito, same sa PRS. Clear coat lang ito at magkakulay sila nitong likod ng body dahil mahogany rin ito. Now, this neck also has ABS plastic binding. At pagdating naman sa shape, hindi ito chunky na neck. Modern C ito, parang mga manipis na Les Paul. Sa fretboard naman, they used Jatoba, a wood similar to rosewood but has a redder tint. And sa inlays, yes, we have the birds again. And if you remember sa Vibecaster, they used Philippine birds. And this time, it's also the same birds. Now, if you're wondering kung bakit walang 24th fret, kasi it's the same template from the Vibecaster. Although I would still love a 24th fret Bird, ang suggestion ko nga ay yung itik na binibenta kapag piyesta. Sa headstock naman tayo, we get the same headstock ng Vibecaster with the RJ Script logo, which by far my favorite version of their logo. It looks very neat. At hindi na rin pala nila kinopya yung headstock ng PRS, by the way. So tuners naman, don't expect that much. These are just generic tuners. I think this will be one of the things that you will upgrade eventually. Mas maganda kung locking. Itong stock nila, medyo mas skip sila. Anyway, bumawi na lang sila sa nut dahil bone ang ginamit nila. So dito, setup na lang ang kailangan. For the scale length, 25 inches. So katulad siya ng isang PRS Custom 24. Now, this is what makes a PRS sit between a Strat and the Les Paul. Sa 25 inch kasi na scale length, may lambot ka ng isang Les Paul at may lutong ka ng isang Stratocaster. Now let's get to the pickups. Nakalnico 5 magnets ito and the McCarty 594 configuration. Two volume knobs and two tone knobs. And it has coil split controls for both pickups dito sa may tone knob. Now with this, you get both the Les Paul tones kapag naka-humbucker mode. And sort of Strat tones kapag naka-split mode. Oh, diba? Kaya ang versatile ng design ng PRS eh. Now for the Deluxe Plus naman, two knobs lang ito, parang Custom 24. Shared yung controls ng tone and volume for the bridge and neck pickup. So if you activate the split, you will split everything ng magkasabay. Kaya mas flexible pa rin ang Deluxe Plus SE kasi with the 4 knobs, pwedeng naka-humbucker ka sa bridge tapos nakatuwang single coil ka sa neck or vice versa. Now dito na tayo sa tingin kong best part ng guitar na ito, the bridge. Tone Master Deluxe Plus and the SE uses a Wilkinson 510 2-point bridge. Ah, the dream. Matagal na akong gumagamit ng PRS at ito lagi yung reklamo ko kasi 6-point trem yung gamit nila. That means it has bad tuning problems. Seriously. Now with the 2-point trem, we can expect better tuning stability. Well, tara, let's compare. There goes my 60k. Well, syempre, provided na ipapasetup nyo yung gitara na ito. So, luckily, this guitar comes with a 2-year setup warranty sa RJ Stores. So, if kukuha kayo nito tapos nawawala sa tono kapag nag-whammy bar kayo, palawagan nyo lang yung nut sa stores. Anyway, kung ayaw nyo nang mahassle sa mga floating bridge, the Deluxe and the Standard models have fixed bridges. Sa Deluxe, tune-o-matic ito parang Gibson style. And the string through naman sa Standard. This is actually to cut the costs hardware. Now, interestingly, these two models are better suited kung plano nyong tumugtog ng periphery or genres na may dropped and alternate tunings. Lalo lalo na dito sa string true. Notice that the break angle is steeper, that means yung string ay mas mahigpit. And this will be handy kapag ka nag-drop A or drop B na natugtugan. Something to think about. Okay, now let's do some benchmark analysis para may idea tayo where the Tone Master lies compared to a stock PRS USA. Both are set up to the same pickup height. Medyo mas specific yung measurements ng PRS, so I'll just flash it sa screen. Alright, so here we have our frequency spectrum graph for the neck and bridge pickup. Ang sample na ginamit natin ay rhythm section ng Stairway to Heaven. Yung white line ay yung Tone Master Deluxe Plus SE at yung red naman ay itong PRS Custom 24 USA. Okay, let's check out the bridge pickup. So output-wise, match yung Alnico 5 pickup ng Tone Master sa 8515 ng PRS. Sa tone naman, we also get a good match sa may body region and note clarity. Take note na sa frequency ng guitars, nandyan yung meat ng tunog or yung character. So we can say that the Tone Master is reaching the PRS tone territory here. Now pagdating naman sa may pick attack and presence region, doon significantly mas lamang ang PRS. Although if we look closely sa may air region sa may 10 kHz, may spike ang Tone Master. So I'm suspecting na same pickups ito na ginamit nila sa Blues Breaker because of that similar bump. Now sa low end naman, sa may warmth and rumble region, mas malakas ang PRS. Actually, yun yung defining character ng 8515 talaga. Well, mind you, may ibang gitaristang katulad ko na nagsaswap ng pickups dahil dyan sa excess warmth na yan. So it may or may not be a good thing. Taste nyo na lang yan. Now sa neck pickup naman, ito halos match na sila, lalo na sa output. Now the Tone Master still has that signature RJ tone na mas leaning towards the bright end. Kasi kung titignan nating mabuti, sa may pick attack region hanggang sa may presence region, match sila ng PRS. And then when we go down sa chart, bumababa yung output ng Tone Master. Actually, maliit na difference lang siya, pero it shows na less ang warmth and body ng neck pickup ng Tone Master. Okay, so that's the Tone Master series by RJ Guitars this 2023. Now for the price, the Tone Master standard with the Tune-O-Matic bridge and string through design is 15,000. Sa Deluxe naman, 16,000. Ang difference lang ay yung stop bar tailpiece. Sa Deluxe Plus naman, 18,000 at naka Wilkinson tremolo bridge na ito. Yung electronics niya, same lang nung lower models. And finally, sa Special Edition, 19,000 with the Wilkinson bridge and 4 knobs. Anyway, for the colors, konti lang inilabas nila for this lineup, and actually limited lang yung stocks, so I guess happy guys. Ako si Pax, hanggang sa muli, tugtog lang.